Thanks for joining us on SAP Developer News. In the next few minutes, our developer advocates will get you up to speed with today's news in SAP technology.
After a long time waiting, we're almost there. Devtoberfest 2021 starts next week, October 4th. Join us live to be part of the Devtoberfest 2021 launch party on October 6th, together with Chief Technology Officer Jürgen Müller and Global Head of Developer and Community Relations Thomas Gressel. Jürgen will kick off the event, talk about Devtoberfest and TechEd 2021, as well as giving us a sneak peek on TechEd's additions for this year. Thomas is going to give you insights on what to expect over the next 6 weeks of Devtoberfest. Learn about the different topic weeks, how the Devtoberfest contest will work, and get a preview for the planned Fun Friday activities. But this is not our only highlight for the first week of Devtoberfest. On Friday, October 8th, we will have a great watch party planned where you can join the developer advocates in a journey through the history of computer science together with the Computer History Museum from California. Right after the watch party, you will have the opportunity to ask questions to Dag Spicer. Dag is the museum's senior curator. He is an electrical engineer and historian of science and technology. If you haven't registered yet, head straight to Eventbrite and do so today. For more information about the event, visit Devtoberfest GitHub repository or the SAP Developer Center. As always, the links are in the description of this video. See you next week for Devtoberfest 2021.
Sharp observers of package changes in NPN might have already noticed the update of the SAP CDS package, and therefore the cloud application programming model overall, to version 5.5 late last week. This monthly minor release of the cloud application programming model brings with it plenty of nice enhancements. Just browsing through the release notes of the Node.js flavor of the cloud application programming model shows a long list of additions, changes, and fixes. We see improvements to messaging support and the CDS.tx API. There's the newly introduced CDS.spawn that allows the execution of background jobs with a detached, fully managed ACID transaction. Also great news, the default server is now cores enabled for all origins, if not running in production mode. No longer do you need to add your own cores library and configuration or an application router if you want to test with a different app serving the UI content statically. Also, the CDS editor now also supports improved documentation comments in both Business Application Studio and Visual Studio Code. The editor will now complete the comment markers for you. As with any of the CAP monthly updates, the list of improvements and changes are numerous, and these are only a few of the highlights. Check out the full listing in the release notes online.
I'm a big fan of OpenSAP. The quality and variety of content there is super. I'm really happy to be able to announce that there's a new course available soon. The course is called Building Applications on SAP BTP with Microsoft Services. On this course, you'll learn about the technical capabilities of the combination of SAP's business technology platform and Azure through examples, practical examples on integration, extensibility, and much more. One of the really nice things in this announcement is that one of the course content creators is none other than our former developer advocate colleague, Max, who has teamed up with a number of great folks to put this content together for you. So head on over to OpenSAP and join the over 8,000 folks who have already enrolled for this course.
SAP HANA Cloud comprises product components such as SAP HANA Database, Data Lake, or Adaptive Server Enterprise. The SAP HANA Cloud components follow a quarterly release cycle, or QRC. To use new and enhanced features available in a particular database component release, you must ensure that your instance is upgraded to that version. On the other hand, SAP HANA Cloud tools such as HANA Cloud Central, Database Explorer, and HANA Cockpit are updated behind the scenes and frequently. All new and enhanced features compatible with the versions of your components are automatically available to you on tools release date. To find what's new in SAP HANA Cloud, please reference to the corresponding section of documentation on the Help portal. For the benefit of us all, this week, Daniel Van Leeuwen from Product Management published an article that summarizes the most interesting new features released in Database Explorer during last quarter. Among my personal favorites are, first, ability to view schemas and tables in SQL on file service, which is used to enable queries on data stored in the data lake files. And second, enhancements in the graph viewer, such as visual execution of shortest path and neighbors algorithms. And if you are interested in the administration tools as SAP HANA Cockpit, then do not miss a similar blog post from Jose Ramos on what key enhancements were released during the third quarter in SAP HANA Cloud Central and SAP HANA Cockpit.